Hello, testing. Hello, hello, testing. Hello, testing. Hello, testing. Yes.
Hello, in the testing. Name of the Father, Son, and hello. Holy hello, Spirit.
Testing. Hello, testing. Hello, testing.
I want to welcome all of us to this Christian week in honor of Professor Idowu.
Hello, testing.
I pray that the God of heaven and earth will be with us and glorify himself in all that we do this evening, in Jesus' name. Shall we stand for the opening prayer?
Let us pray. Everlasting Father, we thank you for the life and time of your son, Professor Idowu Iweibo. Thank you for a beautiful family life, and thank you for a successful career. Lord, we commit this service of Christian Week unto you. We ask that you take control in the name of Jesus Christ. We ask, O Lord, that everything we do in this service will be according to your will in the name of Jesus. We pray, O Lord, that you continue to abide with the family of your son and every one of us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for answered prayers, for we pray through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior.
We remain standing for the opening hymn, Immortal, Invisible, God Only Wise.
Hello.
Mr. Ijewoman Iweibo to take the first scripture reading. I want to invite Ahizi Iweibo to take the next reading.
As we remain seated, we shall take the next hymn on page 5, item 6. The King of Love, My Shepherd Is.
Thank you. Praise the Lord. The third Bible reading is taken from Revelation chapter 7, verse 9 to 17. After these things I looked, and behold, a great multitude, which no one could number, of all nations, tribes, peoples, and tongues, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed with white robes, with palm branches in their hands, and crying out with a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God, who sits on the throne, and to the Lamb." All the angels stood around the throne, and the elders and the four living creatures, and fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, saying, "Amen, blessing and glory and wisdom, thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders answered, saying, "Who are these arrayed in white robes? And where did they come from?" And I said to him, "Sir, you know." So he said to me, "These are the ones who come out of the great tribulation and washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore, they are before the throne of God and serve him day and night in his temple. And he who sits on the throne will dwell among them. They shall neither hunger anymore nor thirst anymore. The sun shall not strike them, nor any heat. For the Lamb who is in the midst of the throne will shepherd them and lead them to the living water, the living fountains of water. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." May the Lord bless the reading and the hearing of his word in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
I invite Dr. Moleo Adio to take the next reading.
Praise God. The fourth Bible reading will be taken from Psalm 112. Praise the Lord. Blessed is the man who fears the Lord, who delights greatly in his commandments. His descendants will be mighty on the earth. The generation of the upright will be blessed. Wealth and riches will be in his house, and his righteousness endures forever. Unto the upright there arises light in the darkness. He is gracious and full of compassion and righteous. A good man deals graciously and lends. He will guide his affairs with discretion. Surely he will never be shaken. The righteous will be in everlasting remembrance. He will not be afraid of evil tidings. His heart is steadfast, trusting in the Lord. His heart is established. He will not be afraid until he sees his desire upon his enemies. He has dispersed abroad. He has given to the poor. His righteousness endures forever. His horn will be exalted with honor. The wicked will see it and be grieved. He will gnash his teeth and melt away. The desire of the wicked shall perish. May the Lord bless the reading of his word.
It is time for tribute and testimonies about the life and times of Professor Idowu Iweibo. And so some groups will be represented. The first I will call upon is Professor Obiegbedi to represent his colleagues. And I want to plead that each testifier will spend 3 minutes. God bless you as you comply.
Good evening, everyone. I aligned myself with the protocol already established. My professors, my colleagues, I appreciate you. Thank you for coming. We are honored to have you here. I don't know how to actually tell the story or pay tribute to my professor. I met him in 1978, 5th of December, when he came to teach me quantum chemistry. And I studied under him as a student, and also I worked with him very closely as a colleague. And there is a saying that if you want to know who somebody is, look at what he's doing and read what he writes. I actually read almost everything that my prof wrote from the time I went into his lab. And I saw what he was doing. So, within a short time, I actually fit into the culture of his lab and his research. So we started work. I want to point out very clearly that my prof, I call him my prof, he supervised my BSc, supervised my MSc, and he supervised my PhD thesis. So I'm really a product, fully, completely a product of him. And what is the culture of Professor Weber's lab? From what I can easily recall, you have punctuality, you have diligence, you have hard work, you have discipline. If you can add some other similar ways of doing things. If you can't fit into this, it's a little bit difficult to work with him. So my prof, his schedule is like every day by 7:30, we'll be in the lab through up to 10 p.m. And if he comes to the lab around 7:30 to 8 a.m., you can't just, as a postgraduate student, coming in at 9. So it was a very serious training, rigorous. He touched my life in the following ways. He recommended me, you know, after the MSc, it was becoming a little bit difficult financially, but he recommended me to be a graduate assistant. And that made me very comfortable in the Department of Chemistry. Thereafter, he also recommended me to be an assistant lecturer. But that was the beginning of my career in academics. Okay. And after some time, he also recommended me for a fellowship in XIUE, Southern Illinois University, Edwardsville, through one of his friends, Professor Egbokari. And when I got there, I was fully exposed to research and teaching. And these are some of the gains I got from Professor. He would like his students to be well trained, seriously trained. So at a point during my PhD, we were three in the lab, Professor Obiegbedi, Dr. Chongwai Paul, Mrs. Fausat Lekshi. At a point, he said, beyond this point, there's a point which you can push somebody. Beyond that point, you need technology. So he told us, beyond this point of this PhD training, you can't understand more. So he went to physics and talked to three professors. He went to mathematics and talked to Professor Laofe. He also went to computer science. So we're out of the department for almost a year receiving lectures. And then when we were through, we're done, we came back. He said, now you can understand. He taught us up to the time we defended our PhD, just to make sure that we're well trained. When people see fear from outside, I and some of my colleagues, we saw human fix, we saw comfort in Professor Weibo. And let me very quickly give the following testimony. When I was about to get married, so one day, because he hasn't seen me like that with anybody, so I decided to go to his house at Sokoto Crescent around 5 p.m. with my wife-to-be, my fiancée. Immediately he saw us. He's the one that did the introduction, because he had eyes for details. He said, this is your wife. I said, yes. And that is how we're very close. Very, very close. And secondly, he's an erudite scholar looking for always a breakthrough in his research. He was courageous. He taught us something. Don't fear people. Respect them. But be very, very courageous. And that is what some of us took. He was a strong character. This one is really a strong character. You need more than ordinary will to work there. And once you fix it, you can operate effectively. And the sky will always be the limit. And finally, okay, when my prof says no, I think you need a superior argument to overcome that. There was work we did. The final work we did before he retired, we sent it out. It was a very large work, big. And the reviewers, two reviewers, one of them, the report was, this work is good, it's very good, it should be published like that. But I'm a user. It's in the area of theoretical chemistry. I'm a user. Seek the opinion of an expert. So the expert also brought his result, said, the work, there are some typographical errors. We've dealt with so many notable equations. We're trying to dismantle them. Then my prof wasn't happy with it. He saw the politics behind the publication. And he made it clear. He said, Nancy, this work will be unpublished. I will not publish it. He just said no. Till today, the work was not published. It's there, about 35 pages. So this is a man that took me as a 200 level student when everybody was saying, that area is very difficult. Trained me. And not only that, was a great help to my family. Made me to a large extent what I am. He was a destiny helper that God gave to me. I will ever be grateful for what he did to me. Goodbye, Professor Iweibo. Thank you.
Thank you very much, bro. That was detailed enough. We pray that the Lord will also help us in order to make people in our own field, in Jesus' name. I don't know if Professor Charles Wakwa is there. If he's not here, I move on to call Professor Larry Dinton, close friend.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I don't think we sound bright enough, because when you listen to the tribute, the testimonies to Professor Idowu Iweibo, you know he achieved a lot. So this is not a time that we should all frown our faces. We have come to celebrate a great guy, a great man of high moral standards, a man of high virtues, a distinguished erudite professor of chemistry, and a man of principle. Once he believed in an issue, it's very, very difficult for you to change him. And once he knows you and is ready to spend his time, spend his resources to help you. I would say we were together for over 50 years, and I can say that I know a bit of him. We were together in Lagos in the same secondary school, the Methodist Boys High School, Lagos. And after the secondary school, we were also together here in University of Ibadan. And indeed, we were together in the same room. So I think I have a very good knowledge of what he can do, and he will tell you what I can do, because we are really very close. Even if after our university education, the family was very, very, very close, and we are still very close with the family up to today. The man, Professor Idowu Iweibo, was a man of great virtues, so talented. Simple, and you don't know, you know, unless you move very close, you know, to him. You know, so in the school, that is at Melody Boys High School in Lagos, he was always the first in the classroom. He was Mr. First, I can tell you that. And nobody during our class said, Our class set is 57.61 cent. And nobody was able to lead his class. Apart from being academically sound, President Iweibo was also a man of other virtues. He was a sportsman. His area of interest is the short distance, 100 meters and 200 meters. And he was also involved in relay events. You see, in Lagos those days, when you are a sound, an outstanding athlete like that, a lot of people run around you. They want to be your friends. In fact, you can always get whatever you like. Anytime we had inter-school competitions, all the beautiful things, beautiful women, everybody running after you. But I can tell you, Professor Iweibo was never diverted. You know, he's ever focused. All those beautiful girls always running after good sportsmen, he will just put his eyes on one side. But for some of us who are, we always help him, you know, in sorting out this kind of problem. So, you know, very serious. He was a skillful footballer. And he captained the school to win for the first time the principal cup in Lagos. And because he's so committed, he doesn't like, you know, these cutting corners. In Lagos, those the footballers always want to use talisman and black magic. Our best goalkeeper, he sent him away because he heard that he was making some black magic, you know, and tally. He sent him away. He said he was not going to be with him. Sorry, I think it's not a thing that you can do in 3 minutes. Because he did a lot, and you have a lot of information to pass on about him. Well, he was a devoted husband, a devoted father, you know, and he spent his time to look after his family, you know, very committed, you know. So we are very pleased, as an old boy of Methodist Boys High School, we are very proud of him. He was a true old boy of Methodist Boys High School. He lived by the ideals of the school principals, and he stayed by the school mottos, non sib sed aliis, and we pray that God will be with the family and all the children in Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you very much, Prof. God bless you. May I invite Mr. Desmond Iroe to represent the family. Is he here? Mr. Desmond Iroe. Okay, I invite Dr. Omoleo Adiho. Yes, to represent the children. Dr. Adio, over to you.
Praise God. One of the songs that Daddy liked was Oshé Ojesu Aomaiyo. Oshé Ojesu Olorun Ayowa. Oshé Ojesu Aomaiyo. Baba Bokwe Tamu Wafun O. Oshé Oshé Gbẹrun wa Oshé Jesu Oshé Oyin Olugbala Ogo Olorun Oba mi Isegun Ore Re Oshé Dad, this is on behalf of my siblings and I, this tribute. Dad, words cannot express what you mean to us and the impact you have had on our lives. You are always there for my siblings and I, right from our childhood. Primary school through to university, and even until adulthood. You used to take us to school and bring us back home. While growing up, I remember your daily ritual of checking on my siblings and I in our bedrooms before going to sleep. Daddy did not only used to check up on us, but if a child woke up hungry at 2 a.m., Daddy would make Milo and bread and get us back to sleep. I had the privilege of witnessing firsthand the depth of your love and inestimable strength of character. Indeed, you are a great man, not one without flaws, but you embody justice and nobility in every aspect of life through your profound values, standards, and principles. You are reliable, trustworthy, honest, brutally frank, straightforward, disciplined, firm, contented, jovial, sociable, and just without fear or favor. You are not just a provider to the family. You are a mentor and confidant, and always had an answer to every problem thrown your way. Your passion for justice, at the risk of losing friendship and facing adversity, is one of the attributes that sets you apart from any other men around us. You lived a life of purpose, always striving to make the world one of those that were in need, that were in a better one. Whether it was through your words of wisdom, your acts of generosity or sheer compassion, you left an indelible mark on everyone you encountered. You constantly reminded us that a good name is better than riches. You never stopped emphasizing this mantra to us, your children, and everyone who cared to listen. Many of you listening today knew Daddy as a UI lecturer, but we also knew him as our teacher at home. He instilled a good reading culture in all of us, such that somebody like me, I could friendly read the Guardian newspaper by age 7. As we grew older, he would also buy the Time magazine, and 4 of us would take turns reading it. He would take my siblings and I to his office and on school nights to be tutored for common entrance examination. He was our chemistry teacher for JAMB exam. He was keenly invested in the education of his children and extended this to our extended family members and children of his friends. Dad, you had an excellent command of English language and always armed yourself with a dictionary when writing.
you yourself were like a mobile dictionary. You could also write in Yoruba language, affixing all the intonation marks, and you spoke Ora, our local language, fluently. One of the fondest memories I had as a kid were the trips to the coffee shop at Social Science, UI, for the midday moi moi and tea. Every time we studied at your office, the reward of a chilled bottle of Coke at the end of the day, after hours of studying, was always refreshing, and we always looked forward to it. You would organize for Father Christmas to drop off gifts for us before we left for church on Christmas morning. Your accomplishments as a professor of chemistry are exemplary. And I don't need to do more than enter your name in Google search bar to remind myself of the high bar you have set for us. Your selfless contributions in the several positions you held while in active service have tremendously blessed many lives, and they continue to testify of this in the tributes they send in. You are also a handy person, fixing broken things and doing several other repairs around the house. Many of the responsibilities my brothers took up at home were because they saw you doing them. You loved gardening, growing plants, banana trees, while we lived at Sokoto Crescent. We ate lots of them, and you also give some to neighbors and friends. You had lots of friends and always made out time to visit them and their families, as well as receive them as guests in our house. You built and maintained trusted friendships with your MBHS classmates, academic and non-academic colleagues, among others. Dad, you are an erudite scholar, outstanding academic, great teacher, mentor, in short, a rare gem. Our extended family was precious to you, as you are always ready to lend a helping hand to any family member in need, however distant. You were a Colossus, and my siblings and I count ourselves lucky to have a father like you. The greatest gift, however, that you gave us was marrying Mom. She's the best mother we could ever pray for. Today, we are comforted. We can put up a brave face, because we know that the life you lived was one of immense impact. We join the host of heaven in rejoicing, because heaven has gained an angel, and to the glory of God, you will join the army of angels sent to battle against any injustice and protect those of us left behind. May heaven grant you the peace and rest the earth was incapable of giving you. We love you, Daddy, but God loves you more. May your guiding light continue to illuminate our paths, and may your precious soul rest in perfect peace in the Lord's bosom. Amen. Before I leave, there's a song Daddy used to sing for us when we were children in oral language. He would take times calling our names. Just a song just to praise children. So it goes like this. I'll just use our names. He used to sing it for the girls. Oba fele lo wi me, omo le wo lo wi me, omo le o no reva, o lo igbe no reva. Kiri o kenke, kiri o kiri o kenke, kiri o kiri o kenke, kiri o kiri o kenke.
Request of the children, may I invite Ajayi to represent the extended family.
Good evening, everyone. It's a privilege and honor to stand before you today to give a tribute in honor of our dear Professor Iweibo. We used to call him Brother Idowu. Was my first cousin. Indeed, he was a gift to our family. He guided so many of us in the right path. His path through life, right from primary school, was marked with excellence, hard work, which he impacted in the lives of members of the family. We, at one point or the other, as regards our academic career, he ensured that, not that only that he was a professor in University of Ibadan, he was also concerned about the education of members of the family. Having, you know, won a lot of laurels and scholarship himself, I don't think any one of us in the family, including the children, has surpassed his achievement in the area of academic excellence. Like I said, he was so much interested in our education, and I will give myself as an example. I could remember when I finished my school cert in Lagos, I didn't do well. And I discussed with Brother Idowu, and they said, why don't you come over to Ibadan? And I came over to Ibadan. I had to go through the Department of Education extramural classes. And after a year, that was in 1977, I sat for the GCE, and I came out with excellent results. That the following year, 78, I gained admission into University of Ife. And that's how he was concerned about every one of us. It was when I was with him, I developed my love in academia. And, well, he taught me a lot of chemistry, just like he did his children. But I chose pharmacy instead. I went on to specialize in pharmacognosy. And to the glory of God, in the family, we have two professors on the paternal side and on the maternal side. I'm one, Professor Gloria Ajayi from University of Lagos. He was very hospitable. UI was our second home in the family. Every one of us who is a Iweibo descendant here stayed at one time or the other in his house. At Al-Zayati Crescent, at Sokoto Crescent, we were all there. UI was my second home. I knew virtually everywhere here. He was very hospitable. He was very accommodating. He showed us that it's only education that can liberate one. And I thank God that majority of us took to that counsel, and we are well educated in our own right, you know, successful in the various career that we have undertaken. The daughter just said, he was very caring. He not only took you to school, he used to bathe you, give you bath. And I could remember Ijewome, whatever the father said is fine now. He would say, my father said, and yeah, he was so caring, not only for the members of the family, but also for the children. We will miss him greatly, but the seed he has sown in the lives of every member of the family will continue to multiply, and we will, by the grace of God, on the resurrection morning, we'll see again. Praise the Lord.
Thank you very much, Prof. God bless you. We are going to prepare our hearts to listen to the word of God. But we've seated for a long time. Let us sing from our pamphlet. We repeat the hymn on page 6, the first and the last verses. Guide me, O thou great Redeemer. The first and the last verses. We sing it standing.
Of no regret of our father, Professor Idowu, Iweibo. I want to appreciate as many of us who have come out to testify to the life of impact our father lived. We have come today to learn from the impactful life of our beloved professor. And without mixing words, we have learned one thing or the other through the testimonies we have heard. We should examine our lives. We should examine the way we live our lives. Because someday, people will gather together to say one thing or the other. After our departure, what will people say about you? Will what people say be in line with what heavens will say? Let's open our Bible to Titus chapter 1, verse 2. Titus chapter 1, verse 2. In the hope of eternal life, which God, who does not lie, promised before the beginning of time. Quickly, the Lord is placing before us this evening the hope of eternity with God. The hope of eternity with God. As individuals, we hope for a better life. We hope to enjoy life. We hope to live long. In fact, some people hope to live longer than Methuselah. Some people have one hope or the other. Or let me say, all of us. It is a good thing to hope in getting one good thing or the other here on earth, as people of visions, as people who are working daily, it is good for us to be hopeful. But I want to tell us that there is a clear difference between having hope in earthly things and having hope in heavenly things. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 19, if in this life only we have hope in Christ, we are of all men the most pitiable. That is, as believers, we can have hope of getting better things here on earth. Good. But our hope should not be limited to earthly things. Your hope should not be limited to the things we can see. So Jesus, or the Word of God, is saying to us this evening that because we are believers, our hope in Christ is not limited to probably making it here on earth alone. We should redefine how we place our hope. Our hope should go beyond the ephemeris. I want to ask us some questions. Do you have the hope of eternity with God hereafter? As Christians, or as many of us that are here this evening, do you have the hope of eternity with God? If anything happens to you now or later, do you have the confidence or the assurance that you will enjoy eternity with God? Is your hope limited on the physical achievement you have? It is good to achieve one thing or the other here on earth, but our hope should go beyond that. Are you one of the people who believe that life is only meant to be enjoyed? Just enjoy life. Someday you die and leave the world. I want to say that life goes beyond that. As believers, when we are talking about eternity with God, we are not building our castles in the air. We are not deceiving ourselves. We are not boxing the shadow. But we are saying the reality of the Word of God. Let us be mindful of our eternity with God above every other thing. Nothing should jeopardize the hope we have in God hereafter. We must learn to place our confidence in eternity with God. Nothing should make us change our mind, or nothing should change our focus. As many people, or let me say, provided you have met yourself here on earth, you should have the hope of eternity with God, because there is eternity in hell and there is another eternity with God. You and I will choose the type of eternity we want to enjoy hereafter. We must be sure that God cannot lie about the reality of eternity with him. Looking at the place read, Titus chapter 1, verse 2. The Lord is giving us the assurance that even before he made the world, before he created anything, he had created a space for you and I in his kingdom hereafter. So the Bible says God can never lie. He cannot lie. He has said it. When you hope that hereafter you will, when you hope that hereafter you will enjoy eternity with God, whenever you find yourself in one trial or the other, it will strengthen you. I appreciate the testimonies we had about our Father this evening. It encourages us. So, as believers, when we have the hope of eternity with God, we'll be strengthened during trials. Not only that, we'll be encouraged in times of sadness. One of the children said something. He said, they are happy because of the life Baba lived. They are happy. They are not sad. And if there is any one of you that is sad, I want to say that you should be encouraged, because we have the hope of eternity hereafter. Hope of eternity makes us live holy. If you see anyone who is living recklessly, who is living without considering the fact that God is watching him or her, such a person has set aside the hope of eternity with God. And that is one of the problems we are having in Nigeria today. When people forget that there is another world hereafter, they misbehave. People forget that when anyone dies, God only put comma to the journey of the person, not full stop. The hope of eternity as believers leads us to sacrifice for the sake of others. Baba lived a sacrificial life. Considering the testimonies we had this evening, he sacrificed not for his children alone, but for people around him. Hope of eternity makes us forsake all and follow Jesus. If you see anybody who follows Christ without minding what happens to him or her, such a person has placed his or her hope in eternity with God. Hope of eternity makes us to be faithful to our confession. We have confessed that Jesus is Lord and Savior. If you forget this confession, such a person can do something contrary to the will of God. But when you have in mind the hope of eternity with God, you will be faithful to your confession. And I want to say this before I leave here. What are the things to do to make eternity with God a reality? What are those things? Number one, John chapter 17, verse 3 says, "And this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only time, the only true God, and Jesus." So, according to this passage, number one thing we can do to gain eternity with God hereafter is to know God and Christ Jesus. I want to ask you, do you know Jesus? In whatever you do, in your career, in your business, do you show forth Jesus Christ? If you know Christ, definitely it will be shown in whatever you do and in whatever you say. So I'm saying this evening, that for you to experience the reality of eternity with God, you need to know God and Jesus. Not only that, salvation in Christ Jesus is needed. Are you saved? You can do many things for God. Probably you are here, you have built a place of worship, you have done one thing or the other for God. The fact remains that, are you saved? Who is controlling your life? Have you given up the control of your life to Jesus? Without this, whatever you must have achieved is in vain. The Bible says in John chapter 3, verse 36, he who believes in the Son has everlasting life. Just believe. Because salvation in Jesus gives us freedom from the consequences of our sins. Are you saved? If you are here today or this evening and you are not saved, you know quite all right that Jesus is not the one controlling your life. This is another opportunity for you. This is another opportunity for you to surrender your entire life to Him. And number three, if you want to experience the reality of eternity with God, you must do the will of God. You must do the will of God. You must do the will of God. The Bible says in Micah chapter 6, verse 8, He has shown you, O mortal, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you? To act justly, and to love mercy, and to walk humbly with your God. So what I want to bring out here is that to do the will of God, we must act justly. You and I must act justly in whatever we are doing. In our places of work, wherever we find ourselves, we must act justly. Not only that, we must walk humbly before God, and we must show love to everyone, just like our Father that we are celebrating today. Live a life of love. And I want to say this: God, the Father, has revealed Jesus. He has given us Jesus Christ as a way to eternity, to Himself. So if you are walking or treading on any path different from this, I may not be able to help. The Bible says Jesus is the way. You cannot reach the Father without Jesus. If you are here tonight and you have not surrendered your life to Jesus, I'm begging you to surrender to Him tonight. Shall we bow down our heads? I want us to just talk to God that, Father, help me to inherit eternity with You. Whatever I'm doing that will not allow me to enjoy eternity with You, Lord, take it away from me.
Precious and awesome Father, the God of all goodness, mercy, and grace. No one on earth can understand You, because You walk in a mysterious way your wonders to perform. You chose your son before the world began. You knew him. And you put him in his mother's womb at a specific time. You ordered his life. You were with him. You led him. Your purpose for him came to pass. In every area of his life, your hand was upon him. You led him through thick and thin to the mountains, hills, to the valleys. The crooked paths he made straight before him. You bless him. How many people that we are born with him at the same time achieved what he achieved before he died? There is so much we take for granted, not realizing that every good and every perfect gift comes from above, Father of lights. In you there is no variableness, no shadow of turning. You so bless him. Look at the family before him. The wife, children, grandchildren, nephews and nieces and cousins, friends, colleagues. He achieved that which he set out to do by a power, not by his own might, but the power of the Almighty God. He had run his race. He had finished his course. And we believe that he's with you. Nothing on earth will cause him to desire to come back to planet earth. I haven't had a glimpse of the glory of God. But Father, you have left a family behind. What do you do with them? You are with him. Will you also not be with him? Your hand was upon him. Will your hand not be upon them? You led him. Will you not lead them? You strengthen him at difficult times. Will you not strengthen them also, Father? Peter asks, to whom shall we go? You have the word of eternal life. So Lord, we put them in your hands, that you show your grace upon their lives and mercy upon them, that they will know that they are not alone. The Lord be for them and with them. Who and what can be against them? Lord, uphold them. It's not easy. However old a loved one dies, you will still miss the person. It's not easy for the widow. Not easy for the children and the grandchildren. Not easy for those whose life you touch for good. Lord, grant them your mercy. Father, console them. They may be smiling, but inside their heart, there is a loss. That's a vacuum. Only you can fill that vacuum, Holy Father. They didn't create themselves. You did. They didn't ask for you to create them. You did it on your own. So, Lord, they are your responsibility. We say, Lord, uphold them which are right and of righteousness. Protect them. Provide for them. Go behind them. Go before them in all their ways. May they know that Jehovah Shammah is always with them in the day and the night. Whatever they're going through in life, and this life is difficult. It's a mysterious world we are living in. But may they have that assurance that the Lord is with them. And so that gives them the hope. That gives them the strength. Father, what can we say? We human beings, what can we say? They are yours. look over upon them. Let your eyes watch over them. Let your hand be upon them. Lead them by the power of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit of the living God. Not by power, not by might, by the Holy Spirit of the living God. That whatever situation they face in this world, individually and corporately, they not be afraid. Fear not. Fear not. For the Lord is with you. That shall be their portion. That shall be their song. That shall be their mandate. That shall be their testimony. The land of living. It is well. It is well. That will be their song. It is well with my soul. Oh, it is well. It is well with my soul. He that gives comfort, comfort Zion. He will comfort you now and always. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
We now invite Mr. Idowu Iweibo to take the vote of thanks.
Praise the Lord. On behalf of the Iweibo, Irure, and the Iweibo families, I say a big thank you for your presence at this Christian week and celebration of life of our father, Professor Idowu Iweibo. We greatly appreciate your love, generous contributions, your visits, phone calls, text messages. I receive phone calls from people I've not even spoken to for over 20 years. Thank you for your comforting words. We really appreciate you. Thank you very much. We look forward to seeing you tomorrow at the funeral. Thank you all for attending today. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Let me begin by commiserating with our mother, Mama Caroline Iweibo. The Lord will comfort you with the comfort of the Holy Spirit, and He will be with you and your children and grandchildren. And I pray for you, the children of Baba. The Lord has brought you to Ibadan. We also take you back to your destinations in peace and joy. That you have come to bury your father, you will never regret it. In Jesus' name. On your behalf, I want to say thank you to our officiating ministers at this service. I begin with our preacher at this service, the brand new assistant chaplain one of the chapel. In fact, this is his first official assignment in the chapel, Venerable Tope Paul Falusi. Thank you very much. He resumed only yesterday, and you are the one using him first. So there is a fine for that. God bless you. Our assistant chaplain too is here, very Reverend S.I. Daniel. Thank you very much. You will notice that he came late. Ibadan Archdiocese Methodist Church Nigeria, they are having their synod. So he rushed from the synod to join us. Thank you for coming, brother. God bless you. Reverend Dr. K.I. Princeway is with us. Thank you, Mama, for coming. God bless you. Ordinand M.K. Aribiri, thank you for coming. God bless you. Ordinand T.T. Dopamu, thank you for coming. God bless you. Chapel Choir, we appreciate you. Thank you for being with us. God bless you in Jesus' name. We appreciate our organist. Thank you for coming. God bless you. Let me appreciate our constituency, the Department of Baba, Chemistry Department, through the head of department, Professor Oluwolabi. We appreciate you for coming. God bless you in Jesus' name. Both ancient and modern, they are here. Both retired and serving lecturers, they are all here. Please let us appreciate them. If you won't do anything, please appreciate chemistry department. You know why? My wife is a postgraduate student. So that is my constituency. God bless you in Jesus' name. All chapel members who are here, we appreciate you. Thank you for coming, male and female. We appreciate all of you. We have our Reverend Mother here. Please, I told you to give me her name for recognition. Since you have not done that, I can see her. You are welcome, ma. Please stand for recognition. Thank you for coming all the way from Lagos. God bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. If I have not recognized you, you are important. So just turn to the person sitting beside you and say thank you for coming. Yes, thank you for doing that on my behalf. My name is V.I. Oladele, the chaplain of the chapel. Now, an important notice for the family and for all of us. The service tomorrow is 10 a.m. Am I correct? Today, you should appreciate me for waiting for you. But tomorrow, we don't wait for people. And good enough, I have some samples of the program with me. So I'm good to go. I want to plead with you. Don't come late. Chapel of the Resurrection, we are disciplined about time. Just as disciplined as your father was. I think they were the one who taught chapel how to be disciplined. And so they handed it over to we pastors. And we have been following that rule. Once you say 10, our 10 is what? Is 10. So please get to chapel on time so that the service can start. We commit you unto God. The Lord will perfect everything tomorrow. And there shall be no regret about this service in Jesus' name. All our people from Edo State, we appreciate you. Thank you for coming. Thank you for coming. How do we greet? Okay, they've said it on my behalf. Thank you for coming. God bless you in Jesus' name. The Lord be with you. Shall we stand as we take the closing hymn? Abide with me. The first, the second, and the last verses. The first, the second, and the last verses.
The Lord be with you. At the end of this service, in commemoration of the life and times of your son, Professor Idowu, we give you thanks. And Lord God, we ask that as we depart, may your presence continue with us. We pray that it will be well with us. We declare that through the love of God, our Savior, all will be well. And when we shall gather tomorrow, we pray for your presence and your full blessing. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. May he make his face to shine upon you. May the Lord lift up the light of his favor upon you and grant you peace, both now and forevermore. Amen.
Bowing down before